Hello students, today we will discuss mean free path and sphere of influence. I am Dr. S.B. Kolle, Department of Physics, Shivaji Arts, Commerce and Science College, Kannad, District Aurangabad. So students, you know according to kinetic theory of gases, it is assumed that gas molecules are all identical and they are perfectly elastic spheres of finite size. The molecules of gas constantly collide with each other because of their random motion, zigzag motion. At room temperature, an air molecule suffers 4 into 10 raised to 9 collisions per second, having mean free path 10 raised to minus 7 meter. Now, when gas is in non-equilibrium state, this random motion, the zigzag motion, gives rise to viscosity, conductivity, and diffusion phenomena. So students, see this diagram. In this diagram, these blue circles are gas molecules. And see here, suppose here one molecule collides with this molecule. And after colliding, the molecule gets changed direction and go to this molecule. Again here collision takes place, again go to third molecule, again here collision takes place. Mean you can observe after every collision the molecule gets its direction changed. It will change its direction after every collision, and the path is zigzag. After number of collisions, if we see the path shown by this red line is zigzag path. And see, between any two successive collisions, suppose one collision is here, second collision is here, between these two successive collisions, the path is straight line. See, again, you can see here, the path is straight line, like this. This path is called free path. Means you can say path covered by gas molecule between any two consecutive collisions in a straight line is called free path. Now see friends, the free paths shown here are not same in length. So we have to use concept of mean free path. Now average distance traveled by gas molecule between two successive collisions is called mean free path. So lambda is equal to S by N. What is S? S is total distance traveled by the molecule after N collisions. N is number of collisions. So this is mean free path lambda. Now what is mean free time? Average time taken by gas molecule between two successive collisions is called mean free time. So tau is mean free time. Is equal to lambda upon c. This is distance in free path. This is velocity. So we will see sphere of influence. You know, friends, gas molecules move randomly in all possible directions, and they continuously collide with each other. So see here in this figure diagram, a molecule is shown here. Its radius is sigma by 2, and other molecules also shown here. The A molecule is in motion and all other molecules are stationary. They are at rest. Friend C, if we draw a circle of radius sigma and center A like this, this circle is called sphere of influence. Its radius is sigma and center at A. So when any molecule comes within this range, it will experience force. Now see friends, you can observe from this figure that if the centers of two molecules are at a distance sigma, then they will collide with each other. If suppose any molecule comes in contact with this A molecule, and if the distance between their centers is sigma, then collision will take place. Reference I have used for preparation of this PowerPoint presentation, थैंक यू।